Welcome back to the second half of our final RoboZone of the season. What time is it? It's title time. Two alliances, six teams, the state championship hanging in the balance. For finals match one, let's bring in Dan Gutowski, Dan Kimura, and Dave Verbregge.
Here's how the championship match is set up with the Dow winner against the Ford winner. And wow, are we going to see some points?
Yep, and leading up to the last match, the Dow winner had never missed a fourth rotor, had never missed a climb. They still haven't missed a climb, but of course they did not get their fourth rotor in that last match thanks to the creative defense.
And the one thing I'd like to point out, the max scores. This is not to be given to the Dow winners. The max score, 507 over there from our Ford winner. So
right.
This is anybody's.
And if anything, the knock on this Ford winner alliance coming into here was a huge variance in their scores. We saw some bad matches from them and some good matches from them back on Ford Division field. But since they've come out here, their scores have been consistently high. You know, 470, a 465.
Right.
So they're definitely within striking range.
All right, the long introductions are over. The customary handshake has been executed. And now we're ready for showtime here.
And so what we're going to look at is on the Blue Alliance from Dow, we're going to look for one rotor and pressure being scored in the high goal. From the other alliance, from the Red Alliance here from Ford, we're going to actually look for, they've been doing a double rotor auto where everybody scores a gear.
The autonomous period begins, the Red Alliance putting that gear up. And we watch the Killer Bees pummeling that boiler. But Red Alliance, boy, did they get a lot of points. 121. Blue Alliance way behind as of right now.
They did not get an autonomous rotor at all on the Blue Alliance. So they'll catch up a little bit here as they start to score their gears. But Red did not get the double, only the single autonomous rotor.
Right, Red missed it by like a second or two.
They
were close. The gear was there. They didn't get it wound up in time.
And they dislodge all the balls from the hopper. So anything goes here in this first championship match. Oh, big scores going in there for the Red Alliance.
Right.
And for the Strike Force.
Switching back to shooting here in between delivering their gears.
So if they had had an issue with their shooter, they clearly fixed it because they just pounded a lot of them into that boiler.
Yeah, absolutely. That's going to put them up about 80 points. Sorry, 70 points.
And they're playing from ahead. They're up a rotor, and they have time to go and take these extra fuel shots. So they're up 23-9 in fuel as well.
Blue Alliance trying to come from behind. We can see that they've got three rotors going, as does the Red Alliance. And back to the boilers for the Red Alliance. Again, it's the Strike Force robot. Now the lead is just 20 points for the Red Alliance, inside a minute left.
Strike Force having a little trouble unloading that gear. The peg didn't get lowered down, and now they drop it.
And it's getting close. We're two gears short on the blue side for that fourth rotor. It looks like we are three gears short on the red side.
Again, the big push will come here in the last 30 seconds when the robots go to work climbing that rope, and the Killer Bees taking one last shot at the boiler before they head for the climb. The ropes come out.
Here comes the fourth rotor for the Blue Alliance.
Blue Alliance getting a big jump. Those robots going right up to the beacon. They light two.
And 469 holding in.
That was the trap. Let's see if they can get back and hang themselves, though.
51-14.
Quick latch on both sides.
Red Alliance climbing, and they light all three beacons. But is it enough to topple the Blue Alliance? It seems like it won't be.
Now, fourth rotor for Blue. Those 100 bonus points, just too much to overcome, I think.
Yep, and fuel was exactly the same, 29-29. And still they get that fourth rotor. Three hangs, fourth rotor. 29 fuel points.
Again, if you don't block the pegs on this alliance, it seems like they're going to put up four rotors match after match.
Wow.
A little bit of defense there by 33, but this is where we see 27-67 Strike Force getting free with a load of balls, and here's where they show us their shooter is fine. Completely fine. Just a stream of balls going, and that's dialed in, right? They're missing a couple. You're going to miss a couple when you shoot, but that was really high percentage.
And Sal, now we've got a timeout in progress. They get to cool their motors, change the battery, talk some strategy again. Dan, does this Red Bumper Alliance do they have to go to that game of trying to play defense? Because I think they have to, right? Don't they?
Yeah, but we've seen them score four rotors before. They were even in pressure scoring. You know, there is a world where they say, hey, look, let's go back. Let's try again. We didn't execute as well as we can and try to bring the score up. But I think that there was a moment in that match where they knew they were behind on the fourth rotor, and they really should have switched to defense to try to lock down the Blue Robots for finishing their fourth rotor.
So this is Mary, the Killer Bees. You guys have one in the bag now, and so, you know, I would imagine some of the pressure is off now because you've got one in the bag, but talk about your role specifically and how important it is.
So my role basically is a lot of the scoring part of the whole tournament, so it's a lot of pressure to kind of know ahead of time which robots are coming to the airship and which ones are already there, and if there's a what time it is so I can know when to drop the ropes. So it's a lot of pressure, and you have to kind of think 12 steps ahead of everything, but yeah. It works out.
Yeah.
There's a whole lot of teams that are going to be moving on, so here's some more first facts. This year, there will be 800 teams competing in the World Championships. 5 teams have won world titles from Michigan. Team 67 in 2005, 2009, and 2010. Team 217 won in 2006 and 2008. Team 469 won in 2003 and 2014. And Team 503 won in 2005 with 67. 74 won in 2014 with 469.
I want a career in robotics and automation, so I chose Lawrence Tech for its first in Michigan robotics engineering program. LTU's brand new STEM complex has a robotics lab where we can design, build, and program robots in a creative atmosphere. And the best thing is, I haven't graduated yet, but I already have a job in my field. I know I made the right choice for my career. Lawrence Tech, possible is everything.
Fundraising should be fresh, flavorful, and simple. We have the perfect solution at Hungry Howie's, DoughRaiser.
Probably one of the easiest fundraisers that I'm aware of. It's a logical fundraiser. You're buying a pizza and you're not paying $20 for the pizza. You're actually paying a little bit less for the pizza than what it's worth. And so to me, it's a win-win.
Go to DoughRaiser.com to learn more and sign up. Welcome to Hungry Howie's DoughRaiser.
SnapCab is Metro Detroit's original Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram dealer, and we're still making the best deals every day.
During the spring clearance event, you can lease a Ram Crew Cab 4x4 as low as $189 a month, or a 2017 Jeep Grand Cherokee for just $249.
Sales service and a superior buying experience. That's SnapCab on Telegraph Road in Redford.
SnapCab, Metro Detroit's original. SnapCab, SnapCab.
Welcome back to RoboZone. The reason FIRST Robotics in Michigan rocks more than any other state is because of the investment from our state. They are the sole reason for the exponential growth we've seen. $2.5 million a year makes FIRST accessible to all schools. Governor Rick Schneider is the one who introduced support to the legislature, and he never misses the state championships.
Talk about the fact of how much fun this is for you just being here.
Oh, this is awesome. This is one of my favorite days of the year. I think it's wonderful. If you look at these kids, the parents, everyone's having a wonderful time. And what a topic to learn about STEM education, robotics. They're going to have bright futures, and this is going to help propel them in the future even faster.
Yeah. And we talk about it all the time on our TV show, RoboZone, is the fact that this thing just keeps growing and growing. We've got 450 teams in Michigan now. This is amazing.
Yeah, we've been leading the nation, but we're not going to stop. I set a goal to pass 500. So we want to keep going because it's fundamentally changing our state. We've got over 10,000 high school kids in this program today. And if you look at it now, you can meet coaches and mentors that were in this program that have gone off to get engineering degrees, success in their careers, and they want to give back. Think about what will happen in 10 and 20 years as young people get through this.
Yeah. And I think what's so important is the state's commitment to supporting these schools, because a lot of them will want to start and they're like, how do we even start? Where do we come? But the state has not just financial backing, but through First of Michigan, you know, has the support from start to finish.
Well, absolutely. I got hooked when I came to my first state championship a few years ago. It was, well, you can hear this place. It was absolutely incredible. So we put dollars aside in the state budget to help propel the success, and it's gone so well. The world championships are coming to Detroit for the next 3 years.
That was going to be my next question. How excited are you for that?
It's awesome. I'm actually going to go down to St. Louis for a day so we can make sure we can learn from that to make sure the Detroit experience starting in 18 is going to be the best. They're going to use Ford Field. They're going to use Cobo. Think about the size. Already in Saginaw, they filled up all the hotel rooms with people coming to this. It's great.
Yeah, it really is great. Thanks for your continued support of everything that's going here. I know the kids love it. And, I mean, these are our future leaders right here.
Absolutely. And they're getting the best experience they can. They're learning from mentors, role models. These companies want to hire these young people. Being at Saginaw Valley is great. They want to get them in their programs. It's a win for everyone. But I do want to thank Saginaw Valley. They've got over 400 volunteers here today helping out.
Governor, thank you.
All of us at RoboZone thank Gail Alpert and everyone at First in Michigan. Props to all of our sponsors, Lawrence Tech, Fanuc, Dow, Ford Motor Company, DTE Energy, and Consumers Energy. At Consumers, from the top down, they can't get enough.
We just so happened to catch up with the CEO of Consumers Energy. She is Patty Poppy. And Patty, you said that you're a veteran to these.
You bet. We've been coming for many, many years. Consumers loves and is honored to be a sponsor of this incredible sort of rock concert for super smart people.
Yeah, right. That's exactly what it is. It is so many different things. It is definitely fun with a capital F, no doubt about it. Talk about, since you've got the hot team represented here, what does that mean? What does that go back a ways?
My husband is a mentor for the Heroes of Tomorrow, the team from Milford, Michigan, but we're also sponsors. Consumers is a sponsor of Team 2611, the Robo Riveters, the Blue Ops. We love these kids. We see the future in the eyes of these students, and we know that our future at Consumers depends on the experiences that they're getting on these teams.
No doubt about it, Patty. Looks like they're ready to go, so I appreciate you taking a second.
Let's get going. Thank you. Right. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Okay, everybody. It's time for one more round of First Trivia. What team has won the most FRC Michigan State Championships? We'll see if someone else can guess the correct answer when RoboZone at the State Finals returns.
DTE Energy is committed to giving back. So DTE employees volunteer thousands of hours, working in over 450 communities, with more than 280 charities across Michigan. Why? Because we don't just deliver energy. We want to empower people in the communities where we live and serve. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
We have only to look into each other's eyes to see the story of our planet. But if we move a little to the left and consider the notion of adding the human element to the periodic table of the elements, we see the world for the first time. We work the new chemistry, and in turn, we learn the secret to a better life, where chemistry embraces humanity.
My passion is architecture. I don't want to sit around passively studying. I need to create. In our architecture studios at Lawrence Tech, we collaborate with students, faculty, and professionals from around the world. And from day one, we design using the same industry standard software the architecture firms use. I really feel like I'm designing my own future here. Lawrence Tech. Possible is everything.
Welcome back to RoboZone. Did you guess our first trivia question? Here it is one more time. What team has won the most FRC Michigan State Championships?
I'm gonna say the Killer Bees.
The Red Storm?
Thunder Chickens, 217.
Rats. Hot team.
Hey, welcome back to RoboZone, and you can sense it, can't you? The pressure's mounting. The goal of every season to finish state champions. Will this be the final match, or will we have a championship tiebreaker? Once again, Dan Gutowski, Dan Kimura, and Dave Verbregge.
Again, if the Blue Alliance wins, they will be state champions in Michigan robotics. Everybody hits their ceiling, and the Red Alliance, you know, sometimes you can be really, really good, but just not quite good enough.
Yeah, but it's not over, though. A key will be to look for those two rotors in autonomous for this Red Alliance, right, Dan?
They only got one last time, but they're going for two. So we'll see if they can get it this time.
So from our vantage point, we see Strike Force pulling up there. There's this, 60-75 missed theirs. They will not get two. 60-75 did not get their gear
on. Blue Alliance, both 28-34 and 469 scored their gears, so there's no deficit in gears this time. It's just the 20 points from Fuel that is an advantage. 21 now, that is an advantage for our Blue Alliance.
Killer Bees leading the Blue Alliance out of the gate. Already up 50 points now, 161 to 115.
All right.
Not a huge margin, but still sizable.
So, Dan, what does the Red Alliance do now? What do they do?
Well, it looks like they're going for gears. And like I said, I think that's the first thing to do. If you can get some quick gears, if the other alliance maybe bobbles a few, you can come back. But, yeah, the Red Alliance is starting to fall farther and farther behind here.
Yep, so Strike Force dropped that one before placing it. Here they're trying again. Now they're getting a little bump from the Bionic Blackhawks.
And now Strike Force getting that gear up, but they got work to do.
And you see 28-34 trying to deliver one and struggling to do so, backing up again. And just so quick, the Bees come in, pop theirs on, and they're gone.
Yeah, and we saw the last time, I think 469 was collecting a gear. They drew a retrieval zone penalty. That's a tech foul that's going to add 25 points to the Blue Alliance's score. That's how we sort of saw it grow by another 25 points there.
Leland Zebrotics getting another gear up for the Red Alliance, but still down about 50 points here inside 1 minute left in this match.
Now 28-34 going on defense against 27-67.
And 51-14, Titanium Tigers, radio problem. They have not been moving for the last, 20, 30 seconds. The reboot finally finished, so they're back in the match now, but that's going to hurt a lot.
Red Alliance takes another gear up, but the Blue Alliance piling up that lead with all four rotors activated.
So all that's left for Blue to do now is shoot some balls and go hang. Don't miss the hang, and it's pretty much lights out at this point.
Right. That's where I even think like 469.
It's not worth it. Let them go and make sure you get your hang. I mean, you've hung every single match. There's no reason to put any sort of question mark on this one.
Blue Alliance. They are putting the hammer down here on the Red Alliance, and we go to zero on the clock at almost 500 points, and the Blue Alliance, Lost Gorillas, Killer Bees, and the Bionic Blackhawks will celebrate a state championship in robotics here in Saginaw.
Absolutely. Again, we saw a lot of out-state teams, but here it is back to Oakland County. Three Oakland County powerhouses here. Working together, two from Bloomfield Hills, one from Auburn Hills.
Yep, so that's what? That's four now for 469, two for 28-34, and I think three?
That's, yes.
For 33?
I believe that is correct.
That's too many threes.
Well, let's take
a
look.
That's a lot of threes.
Let's do our replay and take a look at kind of where the separation came for the Blue Alliance.
So that big hit there may be contributing to the Titanium Tigers issues later in the match. But a couple of clean gears being scored by our Blue Alliance.
And here's a close-up of that. Boom, they're there. It's gone.
Just,
they're
it's
on their
so
way.
So fast, right? And that's what you need to be able to do. And then they poached another gear. So the other Alliance dropped that gear on the floor. They didn't have to cross the entire field there. It was just waiting for them. So that's two gears real fast.
Yeah, and that pickup from the floor is huge to be able to do that.
Yeah, the Red Alliance was kind of struggling to get their gears up. They just kind of couldn't really get their mojo back.
Yeah, I think if there's anything, you know, a lesson learned to me.
Who's enjoying it more, the kids or the adults?
Well, I know there's one adult out there who's a big kid. And he is your RoboZone star. And he's enjoying it. And I can't imagine how many hours Jim Zondag puts in. I don't know if he sleeps.
Hey, you know what? I don't think he even thinks it's work.
I don't think so.
Not based on that face.
Yeah, no way.
Yeah.
The Blue Alliance is our champion in Michigan Robotics this year. The Gloss Gorillas, the Killer Bees, the Biotic Blackhawks. Let's go to the winner's circle and join Lauren Plant. Lauren?
Thank you very much, guys. You did a great job, but these guys, getting it done. Unbelievable. What a performance today by literally all three. You guys couldn't have done it without each other. First off, tell me your name.
My name is Peter.
Peter, what do you think ultimately was the difference in why you guys put on such a dominating performance?
Well, we decided that the only way to beat our strategy was with our own strategy. So at this point, it was just a matter of execution. And we executed.
You guys had a ton of tough matches, but what would you say is your hardest one?
Let's see. I would think against the finals of the Dow division against 67 and their alliance. They put up a really good fight, and that was probably the hardest one.
You swept.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, talk about that achievement.
Oh, yeah. All right, so it all started in alliance selection. 469 slipped through the cracks. Oh, my goodness. They slipped through, and we were able to pick them up. We also got Blackhawks over here picking up gears from the floor. You know it. Always hanging. And then we just keep winning four rotors after four rotors. I don't think we missed four rotors once. Oh, wait, yeah. Once. No. Engineers played sneaky strategy on us. But, hey, props to them. They are smart people, and I love them all. And thank you, RoboZone. I love RoboZone.
Right, and now it's time for Worlds.
Yeah!
Jim Zondag and Dan Kimura wrap it all up with me coming up in just a bit. But our final Steamworks shout-out of the season has to go to the incredible support staff that makes FIRST Robotics competitions in Michigan go. You have no idea the hundreds of volunteers committed to the kids and the growth of FIRST Robotics in Michigan just at the state championships alone. 350 volunteers making everything run smoothly. That doesn't even count the 400 Saginaw Valley State volunteers. Everybody finding a way to have a great time and make it great for all of us. There are over 1,700 volunteers in total for the entire season. We salute all of them. It couldn't be done without you. Our final Steamworks shout out goes to you.
Fanuc America is known for their bright yellow robots, but now they're going green with their new string of collaborative robots.
So a collaborative robot is going to be a robot that you're able to stand next to and work directly with. Maybe you're working on the same work piece as the robot, or if you're picking up something heavy, the robot will be able to go over and pick up that heavy object so that you're not straining your back or your muscles.
Having a collaborative robot can improve precision and eliminate mundane tasks for employees. The collaborative robots move slower, have a hand guiding rail, and are sensitive to touch, which allows people to work in conjunction with the robot. And in true Fanuc fashion, they are now taking the collaborative robots to classrooms all around the country.
We started putting the collaborative robots on our cert cart, and so that allows people to learn how to program the robots. And the nice thing about using the collaborative robot, students can work right alongside it.
To get a collaborative robot in your school, visit fanucamerica.com/cert. For RoboZone, I'm Kiara Hay.
Genius is not born. It's nurtured. It's curious. Genius takes teamwork, patience. It keeps going until that moment when it shines. Introducing the Generation Genius Project, a consumers energy educational initiative to inspire a passion in science, technology, engineering, and math. Discover the genius in all of us.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is finished. The state finals have ended. Jim, congratulations.
Thank you, Lauren. It's tremendous.
I mean, this is amazing. Your former team is part of the alliance. What, did we rig something here?
Yeah, it almost looks that way, but no collusion.
Yeah, no collusion whatsoever. They wouldn't think of that. No, seriously, talk about just quickly your run through this day, because it was impressive.
It was a great run. We really had a great trio of teams all filling their parts in, but we went undefeated all the way through, 10-0 through the playoffs, winning the Dow Division Championship, and moving on to win the Michigan State Championship. It was really great. Las Gorillas really throwing down the defense, and Bloomfield Hills, 28-34, running more gears. That's why they were number one pick, running more gears than anybody else here in qualifying. We picked them, backing us up. And again, in a couple of the matches, us, the Killer Bees, the fuel bonus, the autonomous 25 points in fuel, really sealing the deal in a couple of those matches.
Yeah, you watched it, Dan. I mean, that was something to see.
Yeah, for sure. We found out, I think, that Steamworks is a team-oriented game. And when you want to win at a high level, you need all three members of the team executing their prescribed role. And that's what we saw with the Winning Alliance.
Yeah. And we saw all throughout the day different strategies, you know, to success and a lot. But in the end, we kind of said this in the beginning of the season, it was going to come down to shooters.
Yeah, again, we got four rotors in every match but one. Again, at the highest levels, if you have three robots that can all run gears, then you need a shooter on your alliance to really break those ties. But really, getting the four rotors, 140-point bonus, really one of the keys to victory.
Well, guys, hey, thank you. It has been a great season of RoboZone. We will be back next year. Good luck at Worlds. And, guys, continue to talk to us on social media, all that stuff. Maybe we'll do some more extra stuff. We got a lot of stuff in the works. And remember, World Championships right here in Detroit next year. So for Dan, for Jim, I'm Lauren. We'll see you next season.
RoboZone is presented by First in Michigan, Michigan's premier provider of K-12 robotics programs. Lawrence Technological University, possible is everything. Also brought to you by the Ford Steam Experience, inspiring the next generation of problem solvers. The Dow Chemical Company, the human element at work. Fanuc America, the leading supplier of robots, CNCs, and factory automation. Consumers Energy, encouraging your inner genius. Hungry Howie's Dough Raiser, your next fundraiser comes with flavored crust. And the DTE Energy Foundation.